A famous Ethiopian proverb underscores this point. Gowan bishan kesad abate ebota, or yabain lij wahat amma.
Egypt and Sudan both called on the UN Security Council to help resolve the dispute after Ethiopia earlier this week began filling the reservoir behind its Grand Ethiopian Renaissance Dam for a second year. Ethiopia is opposed to any Security Council involvement. The U.S. Ambassador to the United Nations, Linda Thomas-Greenfield, told the Council that a balanced and equitable solution to the filling and operation of the GERD can be reached with political commitment from all parties. Ethiopia says the dam is crucial to its economic development and provide power, although Egypt views it as a grave threat to its Nile water supplies, on which it is almost entirely dependent, while Sudan has expressed concern about the dam's safety and impact on its own dams and water stations. Tunisia has proposed a draft Security Council resolution that would call for a binding agreement between Ethiopia, Sudan, and Egypt on the operation of the giant dam within 6 months, although it was not clear if or when it could be put to a vote. The Grand Ethiopian Renaissance Dam, which will be the largest in Africa, once completed, it is expected to generate more than 6,000 megawatts of electricity. Justice Philip Odoch ruled that and issued an order against the respondents to intervene by making regulations on fees chargeable by hospitals on management and treatment of persons suffering from COVID-19. The issued order also compelled the second respondent, Uganda Medical and Dental Practitioners Council, to make recommendations to the Ministry of Health on reasonable fees for persons seeking and accessing COVID-19 treatment from hospitals, with each party bearing its own costs. Lawyers representing the petitioners had wanted court to issue timelines to government for effecting its orders, but Justice Odoch declined, arguing that since there is goodwill from government to sort out this fees mess, there was no need. The judge added that in case the government does not comply with his orders, then the petitioners can always come to court for enforcement. This case was filed about 2 weeks ago as Mr. Mulumba and Seherd sought court intervention over high medical bills that private hospitals were charging COVID-19 patients following the recent second wave of COVID-19.